Our dictionary corner guest is Lord Grey, Michael Grey, television expert, showbiz agent, and even to Hollywood at one time, didn't you?
Yes, I worked in television in Hollywood, but I did quite a bit of work in Las Vegas when I was an agent, booking acts in the mecca of showbiz.
Is that British acts you were booking?
Yes, and I had the contact in Las Vegas at the Flamingo Hotel, and I was able to persuade him to come and see Tom Jones in London, and he booked him in Las Vegas, so that was exciting. But what made it memorable was that I went for Tom's opening in Las Vegas, and on the third night there was a knock at the, I was in the dressing room, a knock at the dressing room door. His road manager opened the door, and there was Elvis and Priscilla. Elvis Presley, that is, in case you get confused. Anyway, after the show, Elvis and Priscilla came backstage, and they sat with Tom for hours, talking music and here and there. I got his autograph, and I shook hands with Elvis, and I haven't washed this hand since 1969.
And that presumably meant Tom Jones was known to an American audience then?
That launched his career in America, as well as he had a television series in America, which my Uncle Lou, bless him, had booked Tom for some series in America. So he became huge, Tom, in America, and still is.
And tell me about Elvis, because you've seen so many stars and dealt with so many, his downfall, did it surprise you? Was it the time?
I was deeply shocked, yes. He just kind of disintegrated into binge drinking, eating, pills, uppers, downers, towards the end of his career. And it's just a heartbreak. I don't know why. I don't know what the reason was, because he had everything. Maybe that was the reason. He wasn't grounded, but he had everything in the world, as big a world star as his ever been in popular culture.
Not unusual that happening in showbiz, the downfall, is it?
Well, not too many cases, but the big downfalls are absolutely heartbreaking.
Sometimes it's because the career started to drop, but it wasn't that in his case.
Not at all. There was something wasn't right in his head somewhere, or he got hooked on some ridiculous pills or, you know, recreational drugs. I have no idea, but the descent was rapid.
And was it?
Yeah, it was pretty rapid, and, you know, he was overweight, and his voice, he had somebody who used to do the high notes for him in the chorus at the back, because he couldn't hit, he would mime it, and then somebody else would do the high note.
I don't think many of us knew that.
No, tricks of the trade.
That's very good. High notes. I could have someone at the back here, couldn't I?
Yes.
Would you have spotted him as talent?
Elvis?
Yeah.
I would hope so, yes. I'm a pretty good talent spotter in my time. I missed a few, though, along the way. I remember going to see, sort of discovering for television, in a live show, I was asked to go and see Jasper Carrot, who was terrific, and I booked him and put him on TV. And there was somebody on the show before him, who reminded me years later that she was on the bill that night I went, and I didn't notice her at all. She said, I was terrible, and that was the late, wonderful Victoria Wood.
Wow!
So, I can't believe I missed her, but her act must have been so bad.
Not necessarily, Michael.
No, it may have been an off night for me.
Michael Grade. Adrian, 48. Ali, you've got to catch up. You're on 7. And it's Adrian's turn for the letters.
Can I start with a consonant, please, Emily?
Can indeed. Thank you, Adrian. An F.
And a vowel.